Hi guys, greetings of the day. So please welcome to my channel. And today in this session, we are going to discuss about the multistage compressor. A multistage compressor overcomes the difficulties of a single stage compressors by compressing the air in different tubes, that is nothing but using different piston cylinder arrangement successively instead of pressurizing completely in a single stage. Now the overall limitations of a single stage compressor is going to be made as advantages by using the multistage compressor. And multistage compressors are usually found with either two or three stages of compression. With such an arrangement, it is possible to pressurize the air to large values that compared to the single stage arrangement. And also the figure shows the principle of working of two stage compressor in the simplest form. The PV diagram is also illustrated in the figure, which is going to be shown in the next slide after one more point discussion. A two-stage compressor consists of a two-cylinder decreasing in diameter arranged in series, which is very important, and wherein the atmospheric air is compressed to the first cylinder to a certain pressure and then passed over a cooler to achieve the temperature very close to the atmospheric air. The air from the intercooler is now passed to the second cylinder, the high-pressure cylinder, where it is compressed to the desired pressure and then delivered to the air receiver after cooling sufficiently in an after cooler, which is not shown in the figure. Now the multistage compressor, the schematic representation or the line diagram, one can see that the figure is going to be the two stage compressor. Now here you can see in the two stage compressor, the cylinder diameter is greater than the high pressure cylinder diameter. Now low pressure cylinder diameter is always greater than high pressure cylinder diameter. That is what we have mentioned there. Now the atmospheric air is going to enter to the low pressure and the piston is going to compress that the air to a desired pressure, and then during this process the temperature of the air is also going to be increased. That the pressurized and increased temperature of air is going to pass through the intercooler, where the intercooler will be having a supply of a water in and water out, which is as shown in the figure, which need not to be always water as the cooling medium, it could be anything else also. Now in the intercooler, the temperature of the compressed air is going to be reduced to the atmospheric temperature possibly, so that we are going to get the perfect intercooling. And after getting the perfect intercooling, we are going to supply that medium pressure or the low pressure air to the high pressure cylinder, where its diameter is slightly lesser compared to the low pressure cylinder diameter, to achieve the higher pressure. And then thus the higher pressure cylinder is going to compress the air once again to the desired ratio, and then it will be once again supplied to the intercooler, which is not shown in the figure here, which is already mentioned, and then it will go to the air receiver tank. The respective PV diagram is shown here in the figure number B, that is 1 to 2 is going to be the low pressure work, that is the polytropic compression is going to follow, and 2 to 3 is nothing but the intercooler, where the pressure remains same, where the process of intercooling is going to take place from 2 to 3, and then again 3 to 4 is going to be the high pressure compression work, and then again it will go for the intercooler, and then it will be supplied to the air receiver tank, which is not shown in the figure as I already said. And then what is the need of intercooling? One should understand, now here if there is no intercooler, the process of 2 to 3 which is shown here will be directly shifted to here. Now one can see the difference. The A is going to be without intercooler and B is going to be with intercooler. Now in case of multistage compressor, the air compressed in succeeding cylinders, and as a result the temperature of compressed air increases to higher levels after every stage. An intercooler is a heat exchanger which cools the compressed air to a safe value so that it can be compressed again and again depending upon the requirement. Now how does the work is going to be saved? Now one can see that according to the statement, if you are not going to use the intercooling, then what is going to happen? Then there may be a chances of the air temperature may go beyond certain temperature, where the ceasing of the reciprocating parts may happen. To avoid that one, the cooling is mandatory. And also using an intercooler, work is also going to be saved. How the work is going to be saved? Now consider the figure A and B here. The net work done in the compressing from the air from condition 1 to 3 is given by the sum of work done in each state, that is work done by the low pressure and work done by the high pressure. Work done by the low pressure is given by the sum of 1, 2, B, A, 1, this is going to be the low pressure work done, and 2, 3, C, B, 2 is going to be the work done by high pressure compressor, which is mentioned here. Then, with the use of intercooler, the point 2 shifts to the new point X. Instead of staying here, it will be shifted to the new position X, as shown in the figure number B. Therefore, the area of 2xy32 is going to be the saving work because of intercooler. Now if this intercooler is not going to be there, then there may be a chances of the temperature of the air is going to be increased to certain beyond the working limits. Hence there may be a chances of the reciprocating compressors may fail. To avoid that one, the intercooler is also necessary. And also using the intercooler, the work can also be saved, but the work is not going to be saved in the low pressure compressor, but the high pressure compressor, the work is going to be saved, because from the low pressure compressor, after compression only, we are going to have this increased temperature. Therefore, in the high pressure compressor, we are going to save the work. If you are going to have one more stage, again, one more intercooler may be used to save much more work. Otherwise, now one can observe that the work done without the intercooler is greater than work done with the intercooler. Thus one can say that using intercooler work is also going to be reduced. So that is the need for intercooling in multi-stage compression. Now the figure which I have shown here is with respect to two stage. It could be written for three stages also, or even for multiple number of stages. And then what is the advantage of a multi-stage compressors? The following are the few advantages. Now, cylinder design made comparatively easy since there is no risk of high pressure, that is the cylinder thickness is not being very high, so we can maintain the minimum thickness of the cylinders. And also multi-stage compressors have better mechanical balance because of using a smaller components. And then the pressure and temperature can be maintained within the limits due to cooling air at the intermediate stages, that is needing that is nothing but use of intercoolers in the multi-stage compressors. And the improved lubrication due to reduced temperature, as the stage by stage compression is going to take place, due to which the temperature of the working fluid is not going to reach the certain temperature, so that we can say that the lubrication oil is not going to be eliminated. And also work done in the compressing the air is reduced, resulting in the power savings, that is what we have discussed. And compression approaches near isothermal due to intercooling, that is nothing but for each stages we are going to try to achieve for the atmospheric air temperature. And then volumetric efficiency in each stage is high, as the pressure ratio in each stage is small. Air handling capacity thus increases, that is nothing but we can have more FAD, that is more volumetric efficiencies, and then reduces the losses due to air leakages. So these are the few advantages of a multi-stage compressors. In the next video session, we are going to discuss about the work done by the multi-stage compressor and what is the minimum work done for the multi-stage compressors. By that, I am going to end the explanations about the reciprocating compressors. In the next video session, I am going to complete it. And if you have liked this video, please press the like in my YouTube channel, and also please make sure that this video will be shared to all the desired mechanical engineering students. Thank you once again for watching my video.